Hello everybody, welcome back. How are you doing? I can see so many fantastic people in the chat. It's always my pleasure to be here with you for these daily creative challenges. If you don't know me, my name is Gladi and I've been your host during this week, and we got 2 day and one more day to go for this fantastic Illustrator daily creative challenge. But before we jump into the challenge and I will tell you how to join and give you more information, I'm gonna go and say hi in the chat because I already see that chat moving up and up. That means that people are writing messages. So let me come and say hi to you. I've seen Wade, and nice to see you, Keith. You have your coffee ready to go. Shortcuts are coming. Colby, nice to see you. Laura, Mayan, Ruben. I'm gonna scroll up because I'm gonna give a shout to everyone. I've seen Carol today. We were in the chat during a Sue stream in the morning, which was very, very fun in Photoshop camera. If you missed, I'm gonna go back into the schedule towards the end of our 30 minutes together. Also real quick, hi to Sherry, to Paloma, Paul, Dana, Christelle, Cindy, Ruben. Thank you so much for being here. Anthony, thank you so much for joining me. Angie and Mrs. Wright. So I think we are ready to go. Good afternoon, everyone. Let me know where you're streaming from. I'm always very curious to know where everyone is tuning in from. I'm in Manchester in the UK. Well, it's super hot today. So I was literally putting, as I believe Carol advised me, I was putting some of my towel, I was getting some water on and then put them in the freezer for like 5 to 10 minutes and then place them on my cat. So I'm actually gonna put it on my Instagram story. I got my little kitty Frida flat on the floor with this little towel trying to cool down. It's very, very hot in here. So if you see me sweating, you know why. And also Keith, thank you so much. We were having so much fun today in the chat with Team Mobs and Asus this morning. Albuquerque also super hot. Right, let's try to get our brain cool with all this amazing design in Illustrator. Let me just jump into my screen real quick and show you how to join. This is perhaps your first time. I know that there are so many people returning, so I'm gonna be brief, but also try to give information for those of you who are joining today for the first time. So first of all, in order to join the challenge, this challenge in particular, you should head on behance.net/challenge/illustrator, and you'll find also, I believe, a link in the chat, or I'm sure the Wade is gonna put a link in the chat pretty soon. Now, the reason why you wanna head here is because this is our fantastic landing page filled with amazing information, and here it is. Wade dropping the link in the chat for everyone to jump on it. So first thing you gotta do is click on the big blue button in order to receive a notification that lets you know that there is a new daily creative challenge happening, so you're ready to join me here. And if you scroll down, you'll be able to unveil today's challenge. So today's challenge, which is right here, is creating business card. But we're not going to create simple business cards. We're going to create a business card with optical effect. So we really want to try to get noticed. Our business card are not going to sit on the table. We just want to make sure that we create some striking effect that will be a good eye candy for everyone to get noticed when they find our business card. But before we get started, while I keep chatting here, and I'm gonna jump straight away into Discord in a second, I wanna make sure that you download here our starter file. In this case, I've been particularly kind. I decided not only to give you a starter file, but to give you a free template for a European and a US standard business card. So you got your file already set up to go. And of course, I'm going to explain to you how to create it from scratch and what is what when we're going to jump in the file. But in the meantime, make sure to click on get started so you'll be able here to download the file that you prefer, or maybe both, completely up to you. But they're here ready for you. As I was saying before we finish, something that is important to do is to click here on subscribe, because as you can see, we got one more day left together. I know it's very sad. And otherwise, though, the challenge keep going. I don't know if it's Andrew after me or maybe Julia. So you'll be able to see whoever is coming next by clicking on subscribe. You're gonna be advised of the new challenge that's just starting. And if one challenge is not enough, you got plenty of other challenges here for you to revisit, complete of video and starter file. They're always there for you whenever you want to sharpen your skills and learn new technique in Illustrator. Another important thing if you're starting is to download Illustrator. You get the chance to get the trial here by clicking on Download Illustrator. But also, the place that I'm taking you now is our fantastic community chat, which is Discord. You can join by clicking here on Join Us, or you have a link at the very top of the page here where it says Community Chat. Let me zoom in. Or you get a link on top of your chat if you are on Behance.net/live. And let me also give you that fantastic link. Here it is. So it's bit.ly, capital I, Discord. That's the place where you can share your work. And let's jump back into my screen. That's the place where you can share your work and get feedback from the amazing mentor in the chat, like Colby, who's also here, and you, Andrew Hockrattle, which is here. And I can see my dad in the chat. Hi, Dad. My dad Guido, learning to use all the Illustrator app, no matter this age. This app are friendly, and I think they get everyone excited. Definitely me, as you can tell. But as I said, let me jump on the other side. I'm gonna fly on the other side of the screen, and I really want to show you where to share the artwork. That's probably the question that I get the most in private, as a private message on Discord. So I'm gonna really zoom in to show you. So you're gonna have to head on the feedback channel here. Click on challenge and then scroll down to the very bottom of the chat, where you will have the opportunity to click on this little plus here where it says message challenge. And all you have to do is to click on the plus and then head into your folder, wherever that is, whatever you got the file to share, the image, and click on open, and you'll be able to share with everyone your image in order to get feedback. You guys have done a fantastic job. You keep blowing my mind. I've actually seen lately people combining challenge 1, 2, and 3 together when we did the t-shirt, which was mind-blowing and amazing. And before we get started, I also want to remind you that we are featuring the best challenges in our creative galleries on Behance. If you want to get inspired, make sure to head on behance.net/galleries/challenges, and your work can be featured. Of course, if you're joining, this challenge will be under the Illustrator tab, and make sure to upload your work on your Behance profile. And I'll show you at the end, but especially stay tuned. Tomorrow is our last day, but it's a very, very important day, because I'm going to show you how to create a curated, super slick project on Behance in Illustrator, ready to go on Behance and looking beautiful. So make sure to stay tuned tomorrow, because you'll get more chance to be featured if your project looks nice and organized. And I will show you how to do that tomorrow. So we're going to talk about the hashtag in order to get your work discovered. You're going to use the hashtag AI Daily Challenge. But I'm going to jump up on that at the end of the stream. Real quick, before opening Illustrator, yesterday we created a t-shirt, which is also for sale. And I'm going to make sure that my volume is off, because I always like to put some nice songs. But this is the t-shirt that we created yesterday. We created a slogan to support Black Lives Matter movement, and the t-shirt is also on sale for you to buy, and all the proceeds will go to the two charity that we selected with Adobe Live, which has been super thankful. I want to thank the entire team, because as soon as I was talking about the project, they were super supportive. So make sure to head on my Instagram, and you will find the link here on my bio. Is I am Claddy, and you'll get the link to the shop here. And that's the t-shirt. Also, you can see how the t-shirt looks like on ASUS, which I thought that is very fun. Fantastic. But let's jump in Illustrator, because we have to start today's challenge. So hopefully you have downloaded the business card of your choice. Of course, I'm working with European style, because right now I'm in Europe, but you also will be able to download the US size. Fantastic. So I'm going to zoom in to show you what are all these little colors here. If you head to your layer panel at the right, and if by any chance you cannot find your layer panel, let me jump on the other side so it's a little bit more clear. You can find it under the window menu and make sure the layers is ticked for you to see the layer panel appearing in your workspace. As you can see, we have two different layers, one that says your design and one that says artwork guidelines. So the artwork guidelines are all these little dots here that I've created, which they tell you a little bit more about the file. So this bleed mark, this red area, is the area that is gonna be cut from the printer. So every word that is red is not gonna appear. And you think, why we're gonna design it if we're gonna trim it away? Well, the reason is that sometimes when a printer cut artwork, can be a flyer, can be any printer material, a page, if you have a design that goes over the page, so let's see, I'm going to use this fantastic Adobe Max notebook. So for example, imagine this gradient will go, when they design it, it goes to the very, very end of the page here. So what happens if I have just a white piece of paper? When the printer trims it down, we're going to have that ugly line and we're not going to have this beautiful, sharp color up to the very edge of your printed item. So a very fantastic trick in order to make sure that your color background stays intact no matter if the trims the trims blade wobbles is to make it a little bit larger than your actual artwork. And that's what the bleed area is. We're gonna stretch our background to make sure that we allow the printer to have a 3 millimeter issue, which usually happens. It's very common. I used to work in a printer here in Manchester. They have very, very big machine and they have like stack of paper like that and they chop them all together so everything moves. So this is very, very useful. Pro tip here. Make sure to use it when you create your design. Then the trim line is this black here. So let me show you very carefully. The red one, this one over here, is the bleed. The black line is where the actual blade goes and chop, and this dotted one is the safe area. So you really don't want to put anything outside of that, because as you can see, we are considering this 3 millimeter, I think half of an inch, on top and below to make sure that if the blade wobbles, our design stays safe. But I'm gonna untick those for now. I'm gonna untick the visibility by clicking here the little eye on the side on the layer, and I'm gonna jump into my design. First thing to do is to click on the rectangle tool in order to show the hidden shapes, and we're gonna start with the ellipse tool. Click and drag to create a circle, and click on shift if you wish to constrain proportion and create a perfect circle. Then I'm gonna go ahead here to my swatches, I'm gonna zoom in, and I'm gonna click shift and X in order to swap the fill with the stroke. And I don't really want a stroke, so I'm gonna click on the stroke and then click on none. Oops, if I move here, you probably see it better. Here it is. So we don't have any stroke and we have just our black circle here. I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller by holding shift, because see, if I don't hold shift, it just gets a little bit distorted. By holding shift, I can constrain proportion. Then I'm gonna click on Command C to copy, Command F to paste in place. If you don't like shortcut, don't worry. You can do all of that here. Say copy, paste in place. You can find all the shortcut here under the edit menu. So now we have two shapes. I'm gonna hold shift in order to scale it proportionally, and also option in order to keep the center at the same. If we press Command Y, we're gonna go into our outline preview mode that shows us where exactly we have the shape. And again, press Command Y to go back into normal view, and again, Command Y to the outline. I know I like to repeat it because otherwise I usually go fast with the shortcut. Click and drag to make sure that both shapes are aligned, and click on Object, Blend, and Make. So hold here, we're not gonna expand it yet. I know that if you work with me, usually we go blend and expand, not yet. So we're gonna go under Effect, this is the new trick we're gonna learn today, and Distort and Transform. And actually, no, we're gonna go to Pathfinder first. And we're gonna click on Exclude. As you can see, we created the area that is blended between the two, we excluded it from the two object, and it's still not time to expand. But now we can go and play with the blend option here from our toolbar, and I'm gonna zoom in so you can see the icon. It's got all these little shapes, because that's what the blend tool does. It creates different shape in between two objects. And we're gonna select specific steps, click on preview, and I think I'm gonna start with perhaps 7 or 8. And I guess that's a good way to start. And I'm gonna click OK. Now let's try to apply another effect, which is the zigzag. Let's see if it works from here as well. So this is a first approach to the design. And I'm also gonna click on smooth because I like to have this design curved. And I'm gonna click OK. And I'm gonna set this to the side. Now I'm gonna pretty much repeat the same thing, but I'm gonna start by doing this effect on the circle. So again, effect, distort and transform, zigzag. And as you can see, in this case, we have the zigzag that happens only on the first shape. And I'm gonna make it very subtle and perhaps keep the size also a little bit more subtle and press OK. And in this case, I'm gonna go to object, expand appearance, because I do want to expand this appearance. And again, exactly what we've done before, command C to copy, command F to play to paste, and then by clicking option and shift to create a copy that is also proportional and keep the same center. Select them both. Probably gonna make this one a little bit bigger because I wanna give it more space between the two shapes. Again, we're gonna create a blend and make, and then effect, pathfinder, exclude. Fantastic. We can go back and play with our shape. And this is just a different variation, just to show you what happened if you do the zigzag before and after. I'm sweating here. I'm not sweating because Illustrator, I'm sweating because it's 100 degrees in here, especially with all the lights. Perfect. Let's select specific steps and I'm gonna bring it up to, oops, let's click silicone preview. Is the optical effects are happening again. And I'm gonna leave it up to 11 for now, and I'm gonna click OK. Something else that we can do here is per start to create some movement. So we can do so by going here into our design, and this is the second blend. And here you can isolate each single shape by clicking on this side of these little squares. And again, to make sure which one you're selecting, you can also toggle on the visibility so you have a better idea of which one you are selecting. So I'm gonna select the little small one, go again under effect, transform and distort. And in this case, I'm gonna click on transform and I'm gonna start to rotate it a little bit to create a little bit more of this wild optical effect. Just use whatever you want, 24 for now, it's fine. I think you can go up to 100 and you see start to create more crazy optical effect. I have already the crazy one on the other side, so I'm just gonna keep this one, which is more optical. Click on OK and then go and click on our blending mode again, because they're always live. That means that we can now perhaps increase the number of steps for how much we wanted to make it really crazy. And oh my god, I can't believe the time, I'm gonna have to really rush here. So make sure to click a shape that's got an empty center so you can insert your initial in there, and I'm gonna click OK. Now I'm gonna press V and hold option in order to create a copy of this one here, and it's absolutely up to you. You can use this shape that is less complex, or you can choose this shape that is definitely more optical. Completely up to you. Whichever shape you decide to use, I'm just going to use here this one because it's right there. Go and right now click on object and expand appearance. Make sure that you always make a copy before using the appearance, before expanding, because otherwise you won't be able to modify it anymore. And in this case, I'm going to just stretch it, and you don't even have to keep proportion. You can just, you know, have it a little bit more loose, because the point is to have it all distorted. And here it is. You can place it at the center. Sometimes you just wanna, you know, stretch it a little bit more as well. So you can put it a little bit offset from the center. I'm gonna move these two shapes over here. And then simply grab your type tool, click once and double click. And I'm just gonna put my initial K and go to your properties panel, select the font of your choice. Again, I don't have much time here, but you can select the font of your choice, maybe something a little bit bold, and I will leave it in black if you like it. Otherwise, if you want to change it, remember, because you do have already expanded your line, you can also change the color of the line. And if you know me, you know that I like Gotham, so I'm just gonna try and go with a nice Gotham here. And here it is. This is our back of the business card. But how does it look like when it's going to be trimmed? Well, Illustrator gave us the possibility to show us this view by going under view and trim view here. And as you can see, this is how our fantastic business card is going to look like when trimmed. If you do wish to have it already confined, because maybe this is a little bit too much of, you know, it's taking too much of your pasting board, go under your rectangle tool, create a rectangle around your business card, and make sure that you hold shift in order to select both your rectangle and your shape, and then press Command 7 in order to create a clipping mask. We've done it also on the previous challenge. You can find clipping mask under Object and clipping mask. You can also release the clipping mask and it brings back the shape. So again, to clip it is Command 7 with both shapes selected. And make sure that the shape that's gonna act as a frame sits on top, and the object that you wanna encapsulate in your frame is below. So that's the final effect. Of course, you can always click here on your artboard and Alt Option to create a copy, and you can go back and use all these fantastic detail that you have here. Perhaps if I really have not much time, but what I will do here is to release the clipping mask, which let's go under here and release the clipping mask. And perhaps in this case I would use a different area of the image, maybe just something that recall what is on the front, so just something like that. And then I can have my still my initial here, and then keep writing down maybe here my phone number, whatever you want. And again, you can still create a clipping mask with this shape and click and drag to select both, and again Command 7 to have an idea. And again, click and drag here with your type tool, just pressing on Alt if you want to copy the same text. Of course, it's gonna have to be way smaller, and you can put your number here. I'm not gonna put my number and you're gonna put your email address on the other side. Of course, the font is absolutely up to you. I suggest something definitely smaller, definitely not as bold for your number. So of course I'm going here very, very fast, but here it is. So we have our fantastic business card. If I got perhaps a minute, I can also show you another quick trick, which it makes it really cool. If you double click on the shape, you can also still modify the shape, and you can go under Appearance, and here under the effect, you can perhaps add a drop shadow under Stylize here. And click on OK. And I mean, that just gives a little bit more of a cool look to the business card. I'm gonna jump back into the chat. I go above and beyond. Yes, I have fun. I enjoy it. I'm in a lucky position that to do the graphic design job, which is the job that I always loved. As you know me, you knew that that wasn't the first job. I really worked hard to become a graphic designer, and I love it. So I'm really, really happy that I can share with you some of my passion. Keith, you made me giggle so bad. Paloma, I'm so glad that you love this. We got two more minutes. So let me show you how to save this one. We're gonna click on Command and Option in order to export. Sorry, so it's Command Option E in order to export. And in this case, we're gonna have a JPEG. So make sure to change your option here. And another way, and click on Export. Another way of exporting, I'm gonna do that real quick. Another way of exporting is also to go under File, Export, and Export As. Your printer, it might ask you to save it as a PDF, and you can do here. You can save it here as a JPEG, or you can use it as you can save it as a PDF with Save As. So those options are absolutely up to you. Saving as a PDF sometimes can help you to make sure that you have the right compression and the mark and bleed, so you perhaps can have the three marks selected. So that's going to show you to the printer where he has to cut. So all you have to do is click on Save PDF, and you'll also have a PDF, so you know how to save everything. If your printer asks, you're ready to go. Fantastic. Unfortunately, I got one more minute. I want to jump into the schedule because we have fantastic people. We started with Asus Ramirez in the morning and getting started with Photoshop Camera. Budubal with a Photoshop Daily Creative Challenge. Fantastic photo retouching with the wonderful Catherine Aisman. Now we're here finishing up the Illustrator Daily Creative Challenge. And Brand Identity with Andrew coming up. Woo, woo, woo. Then we have Adobe XD with our Pinsky with another Daily Creative Challenge, followed by the lovely Draw Along with Kyle Webster. Closing the day, the fantastic Voodoo Val and Cody Bear. It's unfortunately time to say goodbye. Stay tuned. Share your work on Discord. Share your work on Behance. And I'll catch you tomorrow for challenge number 5, our last challenge together. Thank you so much, everyone. I will see you tomorrow.